Yes, hello guys, welcome on Yourpedia platform. I hope you all are fine, preparing well. So guys, in today's class we are going to solve XE paper 2019. You know, till now we have solved paper 2021, 2020 also we have solved, and guys, today's class we are going to solve paper code E, thermodynamics, 22 questions we are going to solve. You know, in those 22 questions, like weightage is 35 marks, 9 questions are of 1 marks, and remaining 13 question you are going to find of 2 marks. Okay, so total weightage of this particular section is 35 marks. So if you are really preparing for XE gate paper and you want to choose this particular subject, thermodynamics, as one of the section, okay, so this series is going to help you a lot, because you know previous year questions are very important if you are sincerely preparing for GATE. So let's start our discussion, guys. I'm putting here question number one in front of you. This is actually a recorded session, so not a live session. So I'm not going to give you any time. So it's my request to all of you guys, please pause the video and try to solve each and every question. If you are able to solve, it's fine, then you can skip the solution part. But if you are unable to solve, you need to watch the solution part also. Chaliye, let's move to next first question. Why question 45, guys? Why 45 is mentioned? Because you know, like 1 to 22, 2021, 23 to 44, 2020 questions, and 45 to 66. Up to 66, we are going to solve question. Okay, because these are the part of 2019 GATE paper XE. Okay, chaliye. So let me zoom it for you guys. So this is first question in front of you. 1 kg of an ideal gas with the molecular weight x occupies a certain volume V at temperature T and pressure P1. Temperature of that gas is T, volume is V, and the pressure is P1. 4 kg of another gas, ideal gas, that is having molecular weight 2x, is added to the first gas, keeping the volume and temperature same. Then what is the final pressure? Very, very simple question, guys, because in both the cases, very clearly he has mentioned you are having an ideal gas. So how you will solve, guys? How you can write P1? So if I write equation 1, ideal gas equation for the gas 1, when there is only one first gas, so what you can write is P1V equal to MRT1, yes or no, MRT. Okay, so this is gas 1, P1V equal to MRT, or it is better to write in terms of number of moles. Why? Because then R will be what, universal gas constant. So let me write it here, N1, okay. R bar T. Okay, so this is equation number 1. This is equation number 1. Further, you can modify this equation, because this P1V equal to, what is N1, guys? You know, N equal to M by M. Number of moles of a gas equal to the mass of gas divided by molecular weight, or mass of a gas equal to number of moles multiplied by the molecular weight. Like this also you can write. So N, number of moles equal to the mass of gas in kg divided by molecular weight in kg per kilomole or mole. Okay, so if you are using this in kg, then you can use this in kg per kilomole. Okay, if you are putting this in gram, then you can use in gram per mole. Okay, so here we want this in kilomole, so I am putting it in mass in kg and this molecular weight in kg per kilomole. So N you are going to get in kilomole. Okay, so in place of this I can write it as M, and M is what, guys? M is 1. So 1 by molecular weight, and molecular weight is nothing but x. So this equation you are going to get. Okay, so it is better to write this equation as equation number 1. Okay, so I am writing this equation as equation number 1. Yes or no? P1V equal to 1 by x R bar T. Similarly, for gas, when you added another gas into that initial gas, what is the pressure? Suppose that pressure is P2. Okay, pressure is P2. Again, the mixture of two gases, you are having that ideal gas only, initial one, ideal gas, and again you are adding one more gas in that. So you can assume that as an ideal gas. So P2V is the final pressure. What is the final volume, guys? It is V only. Okay, what is the final number of moles? Those are N1 plus N2. Okay, final number of moles are not N2. Means it is not like that ki you are adding N2, so you can write that equation. No. So the initial gas is there and some more gas you are adding. So exactly the moles you are going to get N1 plus L2. These are the total number of moles. You added some new moles, N2, and N1 are the initial moles, into R bar T. Again, R bar is a universal gas constant and T is the same temperature, because it is clearly mentioned volume and temperature are same. Further, you can modify this equation something like this. P2V into, what is N1, guys? Can I write here 1 by X? Yes. What is N2? In place of N2, I can write it here 4 by, what is the molecular weight of second gas, guys? It is 2X. The 4 kg of gas means mass is 4 kg and the molecular weight is 2x. Okay, so you can write it here 2x into r bar t. Okay, so this is equation number 2. Further, you can modify this and then you can name this equation. So it is something like this, p2v equal to, here if you will take common, kya common le sakte, we can take 2x common, LCM, sorry, we can take 2x LCM. So it will be what, 2 plus 4, okay, r bar t, or you can write it as 6 by 2, then you will have 3 by x r bar t. So this is the equation you are going to get, and you can name this equation as equation 2. Okay, this is equation number 2. Now if you will divide equation 1 by 2, dividing equation 1 by 2, what you will have, guys? You will have p1 by p2, okay, you can check, guys. This is 6 by 2, you will have 3 by x. So p1 by p2, volume will cancel out, and here you will have 1 by x, and divide by this, you will have x by 3, okay, x by 3, and this rt will also cancel out. So this xx will also cancel out, okay, so, and you will have p2 equal to 3 times of the p1. Okay, so this is the answer we are getting. You also can check your answer, guys. I am getting this p2 equal to 3 times of the p1. Okay, and if you will check the option, option B is the right answer for this question. Okay, this is the right answer for this question, guys. So very simple question. Okay, I hope you are able to solve these type of very simple question, guys. Ideal gas equation you need to use, but what you need to understand, when you are like the mixture you are treating as an ideal gas, so the number of moles will be what, N1 plus N2, that you need to understand. It is not N2 only, it will be N1 plus N2. Okay, chali. Very simple question, guys, in front of you, and I think everybody will be easily able to answer. Which of the following is an intensive property? Enthalpy, internal energy, entropy or pressure, all are properties, but which one is the intensive property independent of size or mass of the system? And yes, pressure is the intensive property. Entropy, internal energy, enthalpy, you know, this all depends on the mass. More is the mass, more is the entropy, internal energy and enthalpy. Okay, so these three, first we are the extensive property, they depend on the size or mass of the system, but pressure is independent of the size or mass of the system, so pressure is the intensive property. Okay, chaliye, let us move to next question. Question number 3. A thermodynamic process for a substance is represented as constant pressure on a PV diagram and constant temperature on a TV diagram. A process is represented on PV diagram as constant pressure, TV diagram as constant temperature. So which of the following statement is true? Means the process is, it is not like that ke process on one diagram it is represented at constant pressure, on another diagram it is represented as constant temperature. So it means that particular process is constant pressure as well as constant temperature. Are you getting this idea? Like suppose if you are having an isentropic process, so the process is going to remain isentropic only, whether you are representing it on TV diagram, PV diagram or any diagram. Okay, the representation will be different. Like on TS diagram, you will have a vertical line if you are having an isentropic process, otherwise you will have a something like hyperbola in case of what, PV diagram. Okay, but it is going to remain isentropic. Similarly, if you are having a constant pressure and constant diagram, means that process is a constant pressure as well as constant temperature. It means that process is surely a phase change process, because you know during a phase change pressure and temperature both remains constant. So the substance undergoing a phase change, substance is an ideal gas. It is not like that. Ideal gas, if you are having a constant pressure, like if it is in on the PV diagram, then the same process, if you are having what you can say constant pressure, constant temperature, it is not possible. Like if you are having a constant temperature, then what you can say, like on ideal gas mein agar aapka kya hai, constant temperature, then pressure can change also. Okay, pressure can change. Like ideal gas, if you are having inside a container, temperature you want to keep constant, so what you can do, the temperature pressure is going to change, you know. PV, let me write it here, for ideal gas equation, PV equal to constant. This is for a constant temperature process. So for a constant temperature process, if you want to keep pressure also constant, to aapko volume bhi kya rakhna padega, constant rakhna padega. Okay, so thermodynamic process is constant line pe hai on PV diagram. PV diagram pe means you are having a horizontal line, means volume is increasing. Okay, increase decrease kuch bhi ho raha, means volume is changing. Are you getting this? It is not like a point on PV diagram, it is a, like clearly mentioned, you are having a you can say constant pressure process on PV diagram. Are you getting this idea? So it is a phase change process. That's why this is the best option. Substance is a van der Waals gas. It is not like that. And such a process is not possible. It is a possible because during phase change, both remain constant. Chaliye. Let us move to next question, guys. Addition of reheat process to a simple Rankine cycle. Let me show you the reheat so that you will be easily able to recall. Guys, this is your Rankine cycle. Here if I will show temperature, here if I will show entropy, and the Rankine cycle look like something like this. So this is a heat rejection process, this is pumping process, isentropic pumping process, and this is your superheating, and then again after superheating you can reheat the gas. Okay, this is reheating. Okay, so this is reheating. Let me remove this curve, something like this. Okay, so this process, let me show it by a vertical line only. So main thoda sa isko kya karta hu. Okay, so it is better to show it something like this. Let me first draw this. So this is superheating, and then again you will have what? You will have a reheating process, something like this. Okay, so let me complete the cycle also. So cycle, you are going to have something like this. Okay, because I want to show this particular point in the slightly wet region, something like this. Now it is looking fine. Okay, so this is the curve, something like this. Okay, so guys, you know, reheating we carry out to what, guys? To increase the network output. If you are carrying out reheating, the area, this net area, this is your critical point. Okay, this is your critical point, and when you are carrying out the reheating, guys, it is going to increase what? This area. Okay, so this area is going to increase. So if I will write it here, suppose this is 0.1, this is 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so what is 6 to 7, guys? 6 to 7 is superheating. 1 to 2 expansion in the turbine. Okay, then 2 to 3 is the heat rejection in the condenser. 3 to 4 pumping process, isentropic pumping process, you can say. 4 to 5 is what? Heat addition. Okay, in the economizer section, then heat addition in the evaporator section, phase change process. 6 to 7 is the heat addition in the superheated section. This is actually a superheating process, 6 to 7. 7 to 8 again is a expansion in the, what you can say, high pressure turbine. Okay, so expansion in the high pressure turbine. This 8 to 1 ko hum kya bolte hain? This is actually a reheating process. Reheating process. Okay, this 6 to 7 is superheating. 6 to 7 is superheating. Okay, guys. And this 8 to 1 is what? Reheating. So cycle is something like this. Something like this. Okay. Chaliye. So reheating we carry out for what, guys? To increase the work of this particular Rankine cycle. Efficiency can increase or decrease. It depends on the reheat pressure. At what pressure you are reheating? Okay. So this is your reheat pressure, guys. This is your reheat pressure. Okay. इसे हम क्या बोलते हैं? रीहीट प्रेशर. रीहीट प्रेशर. ओके, एट व्हाट प्रेशर यू आर रीहीटिंग, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन दैट. एफिशिएंसी कैन इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज, बट यू कैन नॉट से कि इफ यू आर कैरिंग आउट रीहीटिंग एफिशिएंसी इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. बट इफ यू आर कैरिंग आउट रीहीटिंग, योर हीट एडिशन इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज एंड योर वर्क आउटपुट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. सो फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन द बेस्ट आंसर इज वट? इंक्रीजिंग वट आउट वर्क आउटपुट, बट नॉट नेसेसरली एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द साइकिल. सो ऑप्शन सी इज द राइट आंसर. ओके, ऑप्शन सी इज द राइट आंसर. ठीक है, ये गलत हो जाएगा. दिस इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग. चलिए, लेट अस मूव टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ए कार्नोट साइकिल इंप्लीमेंटेड यूजिंग एन आइडियल गैस इन ए पिस्टन सिलेंडर सिस्टम विल हैव. वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन, वन मार्क्स क्वेश्चन, बट अच्छा है. ओके, यू नीड टू थिंक एंड यू नीड टू आंसर. कार्नोट साइकिल इंप्लीमेंटेड यूजिंग एन आइडियल गैस इन ए पिस्टन सिलेंडर इंजन. So if I will draw it here, the Carnot cycle का अगर मैं PV diagram बनाता हूँ, okay, so the PV diagram for Carnot cycle looks like something like this. Okay, this is your Carnot cycle. Let me name. So 1 to 2 isothermal, okay, 2 to 3 isentropic process, 3 to 4 again isothermal, and this is what guys, this is again isentropic. Okay, so in this process guys, we are having two isothermal process and two isentropic process. Isothermal, this isothermal heat rejection, then isentropic compression process, then isothermal heat rejection, and then you will have what, addition, this is addition, and then you will have isentropic expansion process. So there are two processes, this you can write it as PV equal to constant, okay, and these are what, PV ki power gamma equal to constant. Similarly, you can draw TS diagram also, okay. So what is asking you, which of the following statement is right? Work transfer in two parts of the cycle and heat transfer in other two parts of the cycle, is this is right? In how many processes heat transfer is taking place? Guys, these two processes are isentropic, means reversible adiabatic. Reversible adiabatic. Okay. And if two processes are reversible adiabatic, it means in these two processes heat transfer is not taking place. Only heat transfer taking place in this 3 to 4 and 1 to 2. Yes or no? Out of four processes, heat transfer is only taking place in two processes. Okay. So that is fine. Means one part we are able to answer ki heat transfer till now. The heat transfer is taking place in two processes. Work transfer is taking place in two or four? What you will answer? What you will say? Work transfer is taking place in all four processes, guys. You need to think. This is what, because in this cycle, there is no such constant volume process. Closed system, if there is a constant volume, boundaries are not expanding, not contracting, then you will have a zero work in a closed system. But here, what is 1 to 2? 1 to 2, compression is taking place. Okay, so work transfer is there. 2 to 3, again compression is taking place. Boundaries are contracting, so work transfer is there. Although it will be negative, but work transfer is there. Again 3 to 4, expansion is taking place, so work transfer is there. That is a positive work you are going to get. And again 4 to work, there is an expansion and you are going to get positive work. So in two cycles, two processes, you are having positive work. In two processes, you are having negative work. Okay, but work is there, work yahan pe hoga hi hoga, okay, in all four processes. Why? Because PdV, if you will find out integration PdV, like whether you are finding out PdV for isothermal process, isothermal ke liye work kya hota hai bacho, P1 V1 ln of P2 by V1. So if volume is changing, always you will have some work in case of what, isothermal. And you know, for a isothermal process, the heat transfer equal to the work transfer. Okay, whatever heat transfer is there, that is equal to the work transfer. Okay, so yahan pe aap kya kar rahe ho, heat addition kar rahe ho, okay, heat addition, and you know heat addition is what, that is positive. Okay, and heat addition is positive, so you are going to get positive work. And here 1 to 2, what is you are doing, you are rejecting it, and heat rejection is what, that is negative, and you are going to get what, negative work. Okay, yahan pe kya hoga, negative work hoga, and yahan pe kya hoga, positive work hoga. And again in isentropic process, when the boundaries are expanding, you will get positive work, and when boundaries are contracting, you will get negative work. But work transfer is there in all the four processes. So in two processes there is heat transfer, in four processes there is work transfer. So the right answer for this question is what, guys? Work transfer in all four processes and the heat transfer in the two part of the cycle. Option B is the right answer. Don't answer option A. If you will answer option A, you will get negative mark. Okay, I think you got the point. Chali, let us move to next question. The degree of freedom of a pure substance at triple point. What is triple point, guys? All three phases coexist. All three phases coexist. Okay, so how many number of phases, guys? At triple point, number of phases are three. Pure substance, he mentioned about pure substance. So pure substance means how many number of component? Number of components are one. Okay, directly also you can answer, because triple point ke liye degree of freedom is zero. For triple point, degree of freedom is 0. But if you want to show F plus P equal to C plus 2, so F plus number of edges are 3, component are 1. So if you will solve this, you will get degree of freedom 0. So degree of freedom is 0 for a triple point. Okay. And the answer for this question is option D. Let's move to next question, guys. The differential of Gibbs function G. dg, differential of Gibbs function dg, you can write it as vdp minus sdt. Okay, you know this Gibbs function, it is actually a thermodynamic potential. Okay, one of the thermodynamic potential, like the Helmholtz function, okay, enthalpy and internal energy, these are the four thermodynamic potentials. Okay, so dg equal to vdp minus sdt. From where you are getting this, guys? That also easily you can derive, because you know g equal to what, h minus ts. Okay, yeah, main specific term mein likhta hun, to g equal to h minus ts. Okay, if you will differentiate both side, you will get dg equal to dh minus tds minus s dt. Minus s dt. And this dh minus tds, what is that, guys? You know TDS equation, TDS equal to dh minus vdp. Okay, and dh minus tds, you will get what? Vdp. So this dg equal to vdp minus s dt. Okay, from where, guys? Because you can edit here, because tds equal to dh minus Vdp. This is the TDS equation we are having. So if you will write it here, dh minus TDS, you will get Vdp. That's why I'm writing it here, Vdp. So this equation you are going to get. Okay. Specific term, you can write it here, small v, s. This is small s, something like this I'm writing. Okay. So this equation ko agar hum use kare, so if you want to write this for ideal gas, he asked you this particular thing, del s by del p at constant temperature for ideal gas. He's asking you this. How to solve this, guys? You know, by Maxwell relation, SPVT, these are the Maxwell relation. So del S by del P, del S by del P at constant temperature, okay, del S by del P at constant temperature, that is equal to del V by del T at what? Constant pressure. And what sign you are going to get, guys? Negative, already negative is there, so this is going to come out positive. Are you getting? Already negative sign is there, so this is coming out positive, because when you are moving left to right, that is actually negative. Okay, so this is the equation which you are having. So this we want to find out, and this is mathematically equal to what? Del V by del T at constant pressure by using Maxwell relation. Using Maxwell's relations. Okay, we can write it something like this. Now he is asking you this del V by del T for ideal gas. So guys, if you will use ideal gas equation, PV equal to MRT, okay, PV equal to MRT, or V, specific volume V equal to RT by P. Specific volume V equal to RT by P. Okay. RT by P. अगर आप specific भी नहीं लिखोगे, if you can write here V only, then also you will get the similar thing. Okay, तो मैं आपको पूरा भी लिख सकता हूँ, something like this, volume only. So V equal to MRT by P. Okay, this you are going to get. And if you write the specific volume, you will get something like this, V equal to RT by P. So if you will differentiate both side with respect to temperature, keeping pressure constant. So if you will differentiate del V by del T, keeping pressure constant. So what you are going to get, guys? Here you will get MR by P, because pressure is constant and with respect to temperature you are differentiating. So this you are going to get. Similarly, here if you will differentiate del V by del T at constant pressure, so you will get R by P. Okay. You will get R by P. So this is the result you are going to get. Okay. So there is no such option with MRP, means these are the small terms, and I mentioned also these are the small terms, specific terms. So this we want to find out del S by del P at constant T, and this is what? Del V by del T, specific volume, del V by del T at constant pressure. So this is equal to what, guys? R by P. Okay, so we obtained this is equal to R by P. So which option is right, guys? R by P means option B is the right answer for this question. Okay, so this is how you can solve these type of questions. Chaliye, let us move to next question. A Carnot engine receives 2000 kilojoule heat from a source at 1200 Kelvin. So there is a Carnot engine which is receiving heat from a 1200 Kelvin source, and the heat received is 2000 kilojoule. Okay, it rejects. There is a Carnot engine, means this is a reversible heat engine. Reversible, because Carnot engine is a reversible heat engine. Okay, it is rejecting heat 500 kilojoule to a sink. Okay, this is rejecting heat to a sink at TS. Okay, so this is sink temperature. Okay, now he is asking you that sink temperature. Aapse kya pooch raha hai? Sink temperature pooch raha hai. What is that sink temperature? So what you can do, guys? You can apply here the cyclic Clausius inequality, cyclic integration of dq by t equal to 0. Why? Because this is a reversible cycle. For reversible cycle. Okay, this we can write for a reversible cycle. So here, if you will put, what is this, guys? This is dq by t, heat addition, and heat addition is what? Positive. So you can write it here, 2000 divided by 1200 minus 500 divided by, means, T sink. Okay, and that is equal to 0. So if you will solve further this, so this will cancel out. Okay, so 500 by T sync equal to 20 by 12. Okay, so इसको भी आप सोल्व कर सकते हो. This will be 2 and then 10 0 you will have 5. Okay, so T sync equal to 25 into 12 you will get 0 6 and then you will have what, 300. Okay, 300 Kelvin. So this is the answer I am getting. Temperature of sink is what, 300 Kelvin. Please check your answer. Very simple, because for any reversible cycle you can apply the closest inequality, cycling integration of dq by t equal to 0, or simply also you can write q1 by t1 equal to what, q1 by t1 equal to q2 by t2. Okay, so three things you know, q1, you know t1, you know q2, t2 you want to find out. Okay, so this is t1, this is t1, this is t2. Okay, this is q1. Okay, this is q2. Directly using this also you can answer this question. Are you getting this? Okay, so the right answer for this question is what, 300 Kelvin. Okay, chali, let us move to next question. Question number 53, and I think this is the ninth question, last 1 marks question. After that we will move to the 2 marks question. A closed vessel contains a pure substance with this much volume. So volume is what, 0.1 meter cube. Saturated liquid and saturated vapor. Okay, this much, 0.1 meter cube saturated liquid. So this is the volume of what, saturated liquid. What is the volume of saturated vapor, means Vg, or isko aap Vg likh deta hu main. So this is Vg, saturated volume of the gas. This is 0.9 meter cube. Okay, the specific volume of the liquid and vapor are this. Specific volume bhi aapko given hai, means VL is 0. Liquid and vapor, yes. So 0.000843 meter cube per kg. Okay, and the specific volume of gas is 0.02671 meter cube per kg respectively. Now he is asking the percentage of vapor in the mixture on mass basis. What is the percentage of vapor in the mixture on mass basis? Means he is asking you this, mg divided by mg plus ml. Okay, what is this, guys? This is the fraction of the mass, fraction of mass of vapor in the total mixture, and this is also known as dryness fraction. Okay, so the fraction of mass of the vapor in the total mixture, that is known as dryness fraction. But he is not asking you fraction, he is asking you percentage. How much percentage of the mass of vapor is there in the mixture? So mg by mg plus l multiply by what, 100. Okay, so he is asking you this particular thing on mass basis. How much mass of the vapor out of the total mass of the mixture? So very easily you can solve, because volume is given and the specific volume is given, you can easily find out the mass. Kaise nikaloge? Dekho. Okay, this is volume, guys. This is specific volume. If you will divide volume by specific volume, you are going to get mass. Okay, to main yahan likh deta hu, mass of liquid. Mass of liquid is volume of liquid divided by specific volume of liquid. So this is 0.1 divided by 0.000843. Similarly, what is mass of vapor? Mg equal to volume of vapor divided by specific volume of vapor. So you will get this, 0.9 divided by 0.02671. Okay, so please try to solve and tell me what you are getting. Let me write here in front of you. Okay, so this you will get close to 118.623 kg. This you are going to get close to this. Similarly, if you will solve this also, mass of vapor, this you will get close to 33.69 kg. Okay, now you are having both these two values, so easily you can evaluate this. So mass of vapor is what, 33.69 divided by 33.69 plus 118.623 multiply by 100. Okay, and if you will solve this, guys, you will get a percentage, you will get a percentage close to 22.11%. okay, 22.11%. so this is the answer you are going to get. Okay, let me check what is the range given for this question, or some option is given. Yes, the range given is what, from 22 to 22.3. okay, this is the range given, guys. 22 to 22.3%. So if you are getting answer in this range, your answer is right. And we are getting what? 22.11. So that answer is in range. So our answer is right. Okay. So I think you go to the point. First, after reading the question, you need to understand what he is asking you. Okay. And then you need to use the data. Okay. Guys, that systematic approach you need to follow initially at the start only. As a teacher, I don't know your level. So that's why I'm having that restriction. I'm going with some those steps. First, I'm reading this question in front of you, then I'm writing what is the data given, okay, and then I'm approaching that particular problem. That is a basic step you need to follow if you are a beginner. But if you like practice more and more, after reading the question only, within second you will be able to understand what he is asking you, okay. And that is a practice, guys, and that you need to do if you really want to score well in this particular examination, okay. So guys, these are the 9 questions. Let us move to now the 2 marks question. Okay guys, so this is next question, question number 10 in front of you. So we are starting with now 2 marks question. So guys, in this question, let me zoom it for you. A gas obeys van der Waal equation. This is an equation, you know, van der Waal equation, which we use it for a real gas. Okay, in this, you know, we consider the intermolecular force of attraction also, and the volume occupied the gas molecule, that also we consider. Okay, other than ideal gas. In ideal gas, there is no interaction other than the collision. Okay, and the volume also we neglect. We consider the particle as a pointed mass with negligible volume. So this is an equation which is famously known as van der Waal equation, where A and B are constant, van der Waal constant, and he is asking you, if you, for this equation, if you want to find out Z, compressibility factor, what expression you can write for the compressibility factor Z? Okay, you know guys, this Z is nothing but V actual by V ideal. Okay, and this V ideal is nothing but what? This is nothing but P, RT by P. Okay, so you can write this as P V by RT. Okay, so compressibility factor for ideal gas, this V ideal is what? RT by P, because you know ideal gas equation PV equal to MRT, yeah, P small v equal to RT, so V equal to RT by P. So this equation you can write. So he's asking you what will be this Z, what will be the expression for this Z, how you can write. So guys, small part, derivation part is there. Let me write it here, the this particular equation. P plus A by V square into V minus B equal to RT. Okay, let me use this equation. Okay, slightly simplification is required. So if I will divide and multiply this particular equation by V, I'm dividing it by V and multiplying by V. Okay, so you can write this equation something like this. P V plus A by V, I'm multiplying this, I'm multiplying by V, and this I'm dividing by V, because this both are in multiplication. So actually this term I'm writing it like something like this, V by V. Okay, so this V I'm multiplying, this V I'm dividing. So you will get 1 minus B by V equal to RT. Okay, so we want this, we want this expression something like this, PV by RT. So this we obtain from this, and further this PV, PV plus A by V, okay, you can write something like this, RT into 1 minus B by V ki power minus 1, okay, something like this you can write, okay, something like this you can write, okay. Further, you know, this you can expand using binomial expansion, because this is something like this, 1 minus x ki power minus 1, okay, and by binomial expansion, okay, one thing you need to correct here, this you need to correct, this B is very very less as compared to V, okay, this is very very less, not more, this is very very less as compared to V, okay. So if you write this expansion, you can write this as 1 plus x square, okay, then x cube, something like this, you can write this expansion, okay, is expansion ko hum aisa likh sakte hain. Here you are having this, so this expansion you can write something like this, RT into 1 plus B by V plus B square by V square plus B cube by V cube, and you will have some higher order term, okay. But as it is given, B is very very less as compared to V, so you can neglect these higher term, okay. Neglecting higher order term, Okay, because these are very small. Why? Because this b is very, very small as compared to v. So that ratio b by v will be very, very small. So these terms you can neglect. Okay. Agar hum inko neglect karte hain, you will get this pv plus a by v. Okay. This is equal to rt into 1 plus b by v. Okay. This you are going to get. Okay. Further, if you will simplify this, because we are interested in this, so you can write this as pv equal to rt into 1 plus b by v minus a by v. Okay, so let us now multiply this by rt and divided by rt. Okay, hum isko rt se kya kar dete hain, divide kar dete hain, and let us multiply by rt. Okay, and this rt we can take now common, so rt into 1 plus b by v minus a by v rt. This term you are going to get, a by v rt, this term you are going to get. Okay, and you know guys, what is this rt? How we can write this? Pv equal to what? Pv equal to rt, small p. So small p equal to rt. Okay, so rt ko we can write, this rt we can write in terms of pressure volume also. Okay, very easily we can write this rt in terms of pressure volume. Okay, so if I write it here, this expression PV by RT, okay, PV by RT, this if I will write it here, and this is nothing but Z, because we want this expression PV by RT. So this RT I am dividing by here, okay, both sides. So you will get it here, 1 plus B by V minus A by V RT. Okay, this is the term you are going to get. Let us check in what terms answer is given to us. So Z is 1 plus B by V minus this I am getting. Okay, so 1 plus B by V. Okay, so here you can take this common. Isko bhi hum common le sakte hain. This 1 plus 1 by V you can common. Take common, so you will get B minus A by RT. Okay, so this term you are going to get. So Z equal to 1 plus 1 by V into B minus A by RT. Let us check which one is the right option for this. 1 plus 1 by v into 1 plus 1 by v into b minus a by rt. So option A is matching. You can also check, I am getting option A, and I think you also getting option A. So please check. So this is the right option for this. Okay, pv by rt means compressibility factor, you will get 1 plus 1 by v into b minus a by rt. Okay, please check, small derivation is there, and you will get this Z equal to this. Okay guys, let us move to next question now. Chali. So this is next question. Consider the thermodynamic relation del Cp by del P at constant T equal to minus T del 2V by del T square at constant P. Okay. If the isobaric thermal expansion alpha, isobaric thermal expansion means beta, you know, but here he is writing that as alpha. So isobaric volume expansion coefficient is alpha is equal to 1 by T, and this, you know, this is for ideal gas. This is for ideal gas. Okay, actually this beta here, he is writing this as alpha. So this is nothing but 1 by V del V by del T at constant P. Okay, and this is equal to 1 by T for what? For ideal gas. This is for ideal gas. So he is indirectly saying ki this gas is a ideal gas. Okay, this gas is a ideal gas, and he is asking you what is this value del Cp by del T at constant, del Cp by del P at constant temperature. He is asking you this value. So this is nothing but minus T, because if you want to find out this, agar aapko ye nikalna hai, del Cp by del T del P at constant T, if you want to find out, this is nothing but minus T del 2V by del T square, okay, at constant P. So we are interested in finding out this. Okay, so if you are able to find out this, you can find out, you will be easily able to answer this. But from where you will get this? You will get pressure volume relationship from where? What is the relationship of pressure volume for ideal gas? That is PV equal to MRT. So you need to use that equation, guys. PV equal to MRT. Okay, PV equal to MRT. So from this you can write V equal to MRT by P. Okay, so if you will differentiate both sides with respect to temperature, keeping pressure constant, Okay, keeping pressure constant if you will differentiate. So pressure constant, m constant, and r is also a constant. So you will get mr by p. Okay, this is the term you are going to get. But what we want? We want second differential. Okay, del 2 v by del t square. So if you will again differentiate this, इसको अगर आप अगेन डिफरेंशिएट करोगे, प्रेशर इज कांस्टेंट, मास इज कांस्टेंट, आर इज आल्सो ए कांस्टेंट, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक गैस कांस्टेंट. सो इफ यू विल राइट इट हियर, डेल टू वी बाय डेल टी स्क्वायर एट कांस्टेंट पी, दिस विल बी कमिंग आउट जीरो. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ ऑल आर कांस्टेंट, दिस ऑल आर कांस्टेंट, सो यू विल गेट जीरो. ओके, एंड गाइस, इफ दिस टर्म इज जीरो, व्हाट विल बी दिस फॉर आइडियल गैस? इफ दिस इज जीरो, दिस विल आल्सो बी जीरो. ओके, फॉर आइडियल गैस. व्हाई आइडियल गैस? बिकॉज़ दैट वाज हिंट वाज गिवन टू अस. Okay, that's why we are writing it for ideal gas. Okay, so the answer for this question will be zero. Okay, so आपका answer क्या हो जाएगा? Option A is the right answer for this question. Okay, option A ही क्या हो जाएगा? That will be the right answer. चलिए, let's move to next question, guys. A piston cylinder system has an initial volume 0.1 meter cube and contains ideal gas with CV 0.74 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Are this at this pressure, this temperature, the piston is moved to compress the gas until the pressure and temperature reaches this. During the process, 20 kilojoule of work is done on the gas, the magnitude of the heat transfer. This is a particular process in a closed system, because piston cylinder arrangement is given, the work transfer is given to you, he is asking you the heat transfer. So guys, you know first law of thermodynamics for a process, first law of thermodynamics for a process in closed system, for a process in closed system. Okay, and this is nothing but what? dq equal to du plus dw. So this we want to find out. We want to find out this heat transfer in that process. Okay, suppose let me write it as heat transfer 1 to 2. Okay, let me write, consider that process as 1 to 2. So heat transfer in 1 to 2, that is equal to change in internal energy from 1 to 2 equal to plus work transfer. And work is given to us. The work is what? 20 kilojoule of work is done on the system. Means the work is negative. Okay, this is negative and this work is given to us in kilojoule. So if you are able to find out change in internal energy also in kilojoule, you will get the answer. And from where you will get the change in internal energy, guys? Okay, so piston cylinder arrangement, ideal gas, guys, this is the ideal gas. And for ideal gas, we know what is change in internal energy. What is change in internal energy for ideal gas? Okay, this work is not given to us in kilojoule per kg. This is given to us in kilojoule. So we want internal energy also in kilojoule. So the change in internal energy for ideal gas is mcv dt. Okay, mcv dt. So cv is given to you, dt is also given to you. This is initial temperature, this is final temperature. Initial minus final. So if you will subtract this from this, you will get what? 123 and 2, 125. So dt is 125. CV is also given to you, 0.74. But what is mass? Mass is not given to us. So from where you will get mass, guys? For mass, you will get using ideal gas equation. Mass you will get from ideal gas equation. P1, V1 equal to MRT1. Okay, from this equation, you are going to get mass. So mass is nothing but P1 V1 divided by RT1. So what is P1, guys? Initial pressure. What is initial pressure? 1.5 bar, but you need to put pressure in kilopascal. So 1.5 into 10 square. This is the pressure. What is volume, guys? What is the initial volume? 0.1. 0.1 meter cube. What is R? R is given to us 0.22. 0.288, guys. This is R. What is initial temperature? It is 298. Okay. 298. Okay, इसको पूरे को सोल्व करोगे, यू विल गेट द मास. ओके, इफ यू विल सोल्व दिस एंटायर, यू विल गेट द मास. ओके, सो यू कैन चेक व्हाट मास यू आर गेटिंग. ओके गाइस, प्लीज चेक व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ मास यू आर गेटिंग. इफ यू विल सोल्व, यू विल गेट 0.174, क्लोज टू दिस वैल्यू 0.174. Okay, 174776. This value you are going to get. Okay. Close to this value you are going to get. So now we are having mass. and easily we can evaluate this du. So heat transfer, sorry, change in internal energy for the process 1 to 2 is mass, which is 0.17477 CV, and CV is given to us what, guys? 0.74. okay, so 0.74, and dt is nothing but 423 minus 298, so it is 125. Okay, so if you solve this entire thing, you will get change in internal energy. Okay, change in internal energy you will get from this. Okay, and if you solve this, guys, you will get 16.169 kilojoule. ओके एंड नाउ इफ यू विल पुट दिस इन इक्वेशन नंबर वन, अगर इस डेटा को आप इक्वेशन नंबर वन में पुट करोगे, यू विल गेट द हीट ट्रांसफर फॉर द प्रोसेस 1 टू 2 व्हिच इज 16.169 माइनस 20, सो यू विल गेट द आंसर क्लोज टू माइनस 3.831 किलो जूल. ओके बट गाइज लेट अस सी व्हाट इज आस्किंग यू. इज आस्किंग यू the heat transfer. If he is asking the heat transfer in that process, then you need to feed the answer, or you need to go with option minus 3.8, something like that. But actually there is no such minus option. Why? Because he asked you only the magnitude. What is the magnitude of heat transfer? Okay, he just asked you about the magnitude. So if he is asking about the magnitude, you need to know to worry about the direction. Okay, and direction you need to think only if he is asking the what is a heat transfer. What is heat transfer only? And suppose if he will ask you what is a heat rejection, then also you need not to put minus sign, because already he mentioned what is the heat rejected. Okay, so heat rejected is negative. So, okay, so you need to put in that case also the magnitude only. But here clearly he has mentioned magnitude, so you need to go with 3.8. So D is the right answer for this question. Okay, option D is the right answer. Chaliye, let us move to next question, guys. A reversible cyclic device. Reversible cyclic device absorb this much of the heat from a reservoir maintained at 265 Kelvin, rejects heat to the another reservoir at 298 Kelvin. Reversible device hai, so we can apply what? Q1 by T1 equal to Q2 by T2, or cyclic integration of dQ by T equal to 0. Close this inequality for a reversible cycle. Okay. The magnitude of rate of work done. He is asking you what is the work done on the device. Okay, so let me draw this reversible device. So this is something like this. There is a reservoir maintained at 265 Kelvin. There is another reservoir at 298 Kelvin. Okay, this reversible device takes heat. How much heat? 400 kilojoule per second. Okay, it is taking heat this much amount and obviously rejecting to this with some work input, because this is only possible heat transfer from low temperature to high temperature. This is possible only with some work input. Okay, this is not possible from heat transfer from a low temperature to high temperature. Refrigerator is possible when you are giving some work input. Without work input, the heat transfer from lower temperature to high temperature is not possible. You know about Clausius statement of second law of thermodynamics. Okay, so he is asking you this work only. Very easily you will get if you know about this rejection. So ye kahan se aayega bachon? This Q rejection, yeah, isko main Q2 likh deta hun. From where you will get this Q2? Suppose this is Q1 and this is T1, this is T2. So if you will go for reversible cycle, cyclic integration of dQ by T equal to 0, reversible cycle. Okay, or directly you can say, ki sir, Q1 by T1 equal to Q2 by T2. So this 400 divided by 265, this is equal to Q2 divided by 298. So from this you will get Q2. Solving this, you will get Q2. So 298 into 400 divided by 265. Okay, guys, solving this, you will get Q2. Please check what value of Q2 you are getting. Okay, so if you will solve this, guys, you will get 449.81. 449.81 kilojoule per second. This is the value you are going to get. Okay. And guys, in any refrigerator system, the rejection, the Q rejection, or what you can say Q2, is nothing but work in W in plus heat addition. Okay, and heat addition or what? Q1. Okay, so you can write it here Q2 equal to W plus Q1. So W will be what, guys? W will be Q2 minus Q1. So the work input in this system is nothing but 449.81 minus 400, so which is almost equal to 49.81 kilowatt. Okay, why? Because this kilojoule per second is nothing but kilowatt. Okay, so 49.81 is the right answer for this. So you can go with what? Option D. Okay, option D is the right answer for this question. Okay, 49.81 kilowatt is the work required. Okay, chaliye, let us move to next question, guys. In a reversible process, ideal gas with Cp 1.04 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, Cr 0.297 kilojoule per kg Kelvin at 293 Kelvin is compressed in a cylinder, means there is a closed system, from this pressure to this pressure. Initial and final pressures are given to you. During the compression process, the relationship between pressure and volume is this. So pressure volume relationship is also given to you. Initial temperature is given to you, so final temperature also we can easily obtain. Okay, because this is the relationship which is given to you. Polytropic process, and for a polytropic process you can write the T2 by T1 equal to what? P1 by P2 ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma. From that, here the gamma, in place of gamma you need to write what? N. Okay, polytropic index. So easily you will obtain the final temperature. What is asking you? In the following option, mark the closest value of the entropy change per kilogram. He's asking you the entropy change. What is entropy change in this process? Reversible process, ideal gas is compressed in a cylinder from this pressure to this pressure. Entropy change per kilogram. He's asking you entropy change means we are clearly, it means the entropy change of the system only. For that gas inside the piston, what is the entropy change? He's not asking you entropy generation. Because if he want to ask you entropy generation, he will write what is the net entropy generation, what is the net entropy change, okay, or what is the entropy generation in that process. Okay, so here entropy change means entropy change of the gas inside the piston cylinder arrangement when you are compressing it. Okay, and gas is the ideal gas. So how you can write, guys? Pressure are known to us, initial pressure, final pressure are known to us, and initial temperature, final temperature also we can easily obtain. Okay, so it is better to use this particular formula, S2 minus S1 equal to Cp ln T final means T2 by T1, okay, minus R ln P2 by P1, okay, because temperature, pressure are easily, pressure are given, temperature easily you can evaluate. Okay, from where, guys? Let me use this relationship. T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 ki power N minus 1 by N. Okay, from this relationship you can easily evaluate T2. So T2 equal to T1, and T1 is what? 293. Okay, 293 into P2 by P1. So this is P1, this is P2, so this will be what? 5. Okay, this will be 5. Okay, guys, this will be 5. So 5 ki power N minus 1, so 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3. So from this you will get T2. Isko solve karoge bacho, you will get T2. Okay, so if you put all the values in this, it is a 2 marks question, but question is very, very easy. Easily you will be able to find out this entropy change in what unit will be what? Joule per kg Kelvin. We want answer in joule per kg Kelvin. Joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so here you need to put Cp in what, guys? Joule per kg Kelvin. You need to understand this. If you will put it in kilojoule per kg Kelvin, you are not going to get this in joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so Cp is what, guys? Let me write it here. 1.04 into 10 ki power 3 into ln of T final. T final is this. Yahan se solve karoge T2 you will get. Let me write the value of T2, what you will get. Okay, T2 kya aayega aapka? You can write it here. Okay, guys. So you can evaluate this, what is the value of T2 you are getting. Okay, so you can evaluate. I'm not having that T2 value, so you can put that value here. T2 value aap yahan pe put kar sakte ho, this T2 value, and T1 is what? 293. Okay, minus R is what? Again 297 ln of P2 by P1, and P2 by P1 is nothing but 5. Okay, solving this you will get entropy change. Okay, इसको अगर आप सोल्व करोगे बच्चों, you will get entropy change in joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so all things are known to us, and very easily you will get your answer. Okay, please try to evaluate, and if you solve this, guys, you will get answer minus 91. Okay, minus 91 joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, this is the answer you are going to get. So all two options are there. 91 is also there, minus 91 is also there. But you need to go with what? Minus 91, because we are getting minus 91. Okay guys, the entropy change per kg of the gas joule per kg Kelvin, you will get minus 91. Okay, please check and you can easily find out this answer. Okay guys, minus 91 joule per kg Kelvin. Chaliye, let us move to next question now. The sublimation pressure of a water vapor, very famous question for XC examination. You know guys, many time, like if you will check previous examination, you are going to find out question from Clausius equation, this Clapeyron-Clausius equation, which we generally use from that equation. The equation is what guys? This is the equation. dP by dT equal to latent heat into P by RT square, where T is the T saturation. Okay, P is the vapor pressure, or which is also known as saturation pressure. So this is saturation pressure, vapor pressure, this is T saturation, R is the characteristic gas constant, and latent heat, LT is what? Latent heat of vaporization. So you can write this as delta H also. Delta H of what? Vaporization. Change in enthalpy of the vaporization, phase change, P saturation divided by R T saturation. Okay. And guys, integrating this equation, you will get a very important equation. You will get equation something like this. If you will integrate it from 1 to 2, last class also we discussed about that. So if you will integrate it from 1 to 2, you will get ln P1 by P2 minus delta H vaporization, okay, divided by R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. Okay, so this is the equation you are going to get, integration. If you will integrate it, you will get this equation. In last, I think 2020 also some similar type of question was asked and I derived this. Okay, so you can watch that video if you want to go into derivation of this. Otherwise, you can go to the theory class also. I derived in theory class also this particular thing. Okay, so here you need to use this equation only. Ln is asking you what? The sublimation pressure of water vapor at this. So at this particular temperature, the pressure is this. At this temperature, he is asking you the pressure. So what we want to find out guys, we want to find out this P2. So P1 is given to us 13 Pascal. So answer you are going to get in Pascal only. So this is 13, P2 we want to find out. Minus, what is change in enthalpy of the vaporization? This is 2840, latent heat of vaporization, 2840, okay. Kilojoule per kg, okay. This is in kilojoule per kg. Okay, so if you are taking this in kilojoule per kg, so R also you need to put in kilojoule per kg 0.46 divided by 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. So 1 by 233 minus 1 by 213. Okay, please check. Chaliye. So solving this guys, you will get P2. Isko solve karoge, to aapke paas P2 aa jayega, the sublimation pressure or the saturation pressure corresponding to some another state, another temperature using this Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Okay. So guys, let me write the here answer in front of you. If you will solve this, you will get answer close to 1.07 Pascal. Okay. 1.07 Pascal. This is the answer you are going to get for this question. Okay, so the answer is 1.07 Pascal. Please check your answer. If you are getting it right, it's fine. Otherwise, check your calculation. Chaliye, let us move to next question, guys. Looking like very lengthy question. Let's see. In heating and humidification process, dry air with relative humidity 10% at ambient temperature 10 degrees Celsius is mixed with superheated steam. So it is something like this. There is a humidifier, so air is entering with the relative humidity 10%, okay, relative humidity 10%, temperature 10 degrees Celsius, this air is entering, okay. Some, what the superheated steam is mixed, this is superheated steam, okay, superheated steam is mixed in this, okay. So you can consider this is state 1, this is state 2 and this is state 3. Okay, section 1, section 2, section 3, something like this. The resultant mixer, this is at temperature, the saturated steam is entering at temperature T and the mixture is, you are getting at 25 degrees Celsius with the relative humidity 50%. Okay, the total pressure is same in both the cases, which is total pressure is 102 kilopascal. total pressure is 102 kilopascal. Okay, the saturated pressure at 10 degrees Celsius and 25 degrees Celsius are this. So what you can write it here, guys? You can write PV, saturation. The saturated pressure at 10 degrees Celsius is what? 1.2281 kilopascal. The saturated pressure here, PV saturation here, is what, guys? 3.1698 kilopascal. 3.1698 kilopascal. Okay, the specific humidity formula is this: 622 PV by PD at dry air. Okay, only dry air, that is actually nothing but PT minus PV. Okay, so for dry air, partial pressure, if you want to write, that is the total pressure minus the partial pressure of the vapor. Okay, so using this formula, that is also given to you. Otherwise, you need to remember this humidity ratio, the specific humidity formula. So, and for this unit is what, guys? Iske liye unit hum kya use karte hain? If you are getting using this, the answer you are going to get in grams per kg of the dry air. But generally, we write it here 0.22 so that we will get answer in kg per kg of the dryer, and he is asking you answer in this only. Achha, he is asking you the answer in grams per kg. Okay, so in that case, you can use here 622. Okay, if you want answer in grams per kg of the dry air. Okay, so he is asking you how much the quantity of steam we added. Isme apne kitna quantity of steam add kar diya hai per kg of the dry air. Very simple question. How you will get, guys? Let me write it here, so that you will get the hint. Otherwise, you can solve this very simply. Guys, amount of steam added per kg of dry air. So this is nothing but W3 minus W1. What is the humidity ratio here? So W3 minus W1 is nothing but amount of steam added per kg of the dry air. Okay, so he is asking you this difference only. And from where you will get W3, guys? W3 kahan se aayega? So W3 is nothing but 622 PV by PT minus PV. Okay, so PT, you know, PV from where you will get, guys? PV kahan se aayega aapka? PV you will get from the relative humidity. Okay, so guys, here you know the relative humidity. Yahan pe aapko relative humidity pata hai, which is the 10%. So guys, relative humidity is nothing but, okay, 10% percentage mein, ya isko agar main fraction mein likhunga, so this is nothing but 0.01. okay, this is 0.01. this is nothing but PV by PV saturation. Okay, PV by PV saturation. So PV by PV saturation is nothing but your relative humidity. Okay, so guys, from this easily you will get your PV. Partial pressure of the water vapor you will get from this, because PV saturation is known to us. Multiplying with this, you will get your PV saturation. So, agar main yahan likhta hun PV1. So, PV1 is nothing but 1.2281 multiplied by 0.01. Okay, 0.01. Similarly, you can obtain PV2 also. Here, PV3, you can obtain PV3. So, PV3 is nothing but PV saturation. Here, the PV saturation is this: 3.1698 multiplied by, okay, this is 50%, so it is what? 0.5. Okay, this is 0.5. Yahan pe bhi main theek kar deta hu, maine ek zero zyada laga diya, so it will be 10 by 100, so you will get 0.1. okay, so 0.1 equal to this. Okay, so it will be 0.1. okay, 0.1. okay, so solving this, you will get PV1 equal to 0.12281 kilopascal. okay, this is PV1 you are going to get. And similarly, if you will write it here, you will get PV3 also. Let me write the answer. What is the value of PV1 and PV3 you are going to get? Okay, please check. PV1 you will get this, 0.122, and PV3 you are going to get 1.5849. okay, PV3 will be 1.5849 kilopascal. Okay, so guys, now we are having PV1 and PV3, so easily we can evaluate W1 and W3. Okay, so W3 will be what, guys? 622. Yahan pe main likh deta hu PV3. So this is built PV3. Okay, so into PV3 is what, guys? This is 1.5849. Okay, divide by 102 minus 1.5849. Okay, solving this, you will get W3. Okay, similarly, W1 will be 622 into PV1 divided by PT minus PV1. So it will be 622 into PV1 is what, guys? This is 0.12281. 0.12281 divided by 102 minus 0.12281. Okay, solving this, you will get W1. Okay, W1 also you will get in what unit will be what, guys? Grams per kg of dry air. Similarly, here will be the unit, grams per kg of dry air. Okay, please try to solve and tell me what answer you are getting. Okay, so W3 you will get 9.8173, and this you will get close to 0.7498. Okay, and if you will put these values here, the difference you are going to get 9.0675 grams per kg of dry air. Okay, so this is the amount of steam we added per kg of the dry air, 9.0675. Okay, up to two decimal places you can round off. So you can round off this close to 0.97 grams per kg of dry air. Isko round off kar dete hain do decimal tak. So you can put this answer, 9.07. Let me check what is the acceptable range for this question. 8.5 to 9.5. This is the acceptable range. Okay, so if you are getting answer in this range, your answer is right. Chali guys, let's move to next question. You can check the solution if it is clear to you. So W1 we need to obtain, W3 we need to obtain, and if you will take the difference, you will get the amount of steam added per kg of the dry air. Please check the solution, guys. Okay, these kind of questions are very much common actually in GATE XE. Cyclometry ka aisa question aata hai guys, so you need to practice more and more if you are unable to solve these type of questions. Chali, let us move to next question. In a vapor compression system, a refrigerant leaves the evaporator and enters the compressor. This is mistake. Enters the compressor in a saturated vapor at 0 degree Celsius. Vapor compression system, refrigerant leaves the evaporator and enters the compressor in saturated vapor condition. Okay, so let me draw here the vapor compression cycle diagram. So first you need to show the phase change curve. Okay, so this is the compressor entry. Compressor entry is what? Saturated vapor at 0 degree Celsius. So this temperature is what, guys? This temperature is 0 degree Celsius. Compressor entry pe kya aapke paas? Saturated vapor. The specific enthalpy of the saturated liquid and saturated vapor at 0 degree Celsius are this. So suppose this is 0.1. Okay, and this is some point, you can write it as, okay, I'm not writing any point here. So H1 equal to Hg, okay, at 0 degree Celsius, at 0 degree Celsius. So this is nothing but what? This is 250 kilojoule per kg, 250 kilojoule per kg, okay. And Hf at 0 degree Celsius is nothing but 50 kilojoule per kg. Okay, so these things are given to us. The refrigerant leaves the compressor with a specific enthalpy of this. So this enthalpy is also given to us. Okay, it is leaving the compressor. So this 2, this enthalpy is given to us, H2. In the superheated region, this enthalpy is what? 300 kilojoule per kg. From the condenser, the refrigerant is throttled. Okay, so this is actually a heat rejection process. Something like this, constant pressure, and then you will have a throttling process. Okay, so the cycle is something like this. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1 to 1, 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat rejection, 3 to 4 isenthalpic expansion process, again 4 to 1 is constant pressure or constant temperature because it is a phase change process, heat addition. Okay, so here you are having heat addition. Okay, and here you are having heat rejection. Chali. So what is asking, guys? He is asking the COP. COP of the refrigerant. Okay, COP is 2.8. Then the dryness fraction of the refrigerant entering the evaporator. He is asking you the dryness fraction here. So actually, he is asking you X4. What is the dryness fraction at the entry of the evaporator? Because this is the point, entry to the evaporator, and he is asking you dryness fraction here. Very simple question, guys. Okay, how you can find out this enthalpy, this dryness fraction? Guys, what is this? How we can define H4? This enthalpy in the wet region, how we can define enthalpy in the wet region? This is nothing but this HF at 0 degree Celsius plus X into HG minus HF, okay, at 0 degree Celsius. Yes or no, guys? So X4, you can write it here, X4, dryness fraction at the X4. And what is H4, guys? We don't know. How you can write H4? H4 is nothing but, sir, this is equal to H3. This is equal to H3. Okay, H4 is equal to H3. So this is given to us, guys. This is given to us. This is also given to us. So if you are able to evaluate this H3 or H4, you will get your answer. And that you will get from where, guys? You will get this from the COP. Okay, so the COP is given to you. COP is 2.8, and COP is nothing but the refrigeration effect produced divided by work in. For a vapor compression system, because there is no such compressor work, also there is no such other than this, there is no such expansion work you are going to get. Okay, in throttling device there is no expansion work. So refrigeration effect produced divided by the compressor work, this is the COP. So 2.8, what is the refrigeration effect, guys? Refrigeration effect is what? H1 minus H4. H1 minus H4, this is the refrigeration effect. What is W in, guys? W in is nothing but H2 minus H1. Okay, so from this easily you will get H4. Okay, so isko solve karoge, you will get H4. So 2.8 equal to, what is H1, guys? H1 kitna hai? H1 is 200. Let me check. 250. So H1 is 250 minus H4 divided by H2 minus H1. So H2 is given to us 300. Okay, minus this is 50. So solving this, you will get H4. Isko solve karoge, you will get H4. So 2.8 multiplied by 50, it is 250 minus H4. So H4 you will get from this. Okay, H4 you will get from this. Isko dekhte hain kya aayega. To 28 hai, 28 ko 5 pe bhejoge, so multiply karoge, it will be 04, it will be 140. So H4 I am getting 110 kilojoule per kg. Okay, H4 you will get 110 kilojoule per kg. Okay, let us put this value here so that we will get the answer. So 110 equal to HF. HF is 50 plus X4 equal to 250 minus 50. So this is 200. Okay, so isko isme se subtract karoge, guys. 10 and 40, you will get 60 equal to X4 into 200. Okay, so X4 you will get from this, X4 equal to 6 by 20. Okay, which is nothing but 0.3. okay, so the dryness fraction at the entry to the evaporator, you will get 0.3. okay, so this is the answer I am getting. You can also check your answer. Okay, guys, and yes, this is the right answer for this question. Okay, so the right answer for this question is 0.3. okay, so 0.3 is the quality or the dryness fraction of the refrigerant entering in at the evaporator. Okay, chaliye, so I think this question is clear to you. Please check. Okay, guys, chaliye, let us now move to the next question. Hot air assumed as ideal gas with CP 1000 joule per kg Kelvin, gamma 1.4, enters a gas turbine at 10 bar 1000 Kelvin and leaves at a pressure of 5 bar. Subsequently, it expanded in a nozzle to a pressure of 1 bar. To a pressure of 1 bar means the final pressure is 1 bar. Assume both these processes to be reversible adiabatic. Both processes are reversible adiabatic. If the inlet velocity to the air to the nozzle is negligible, inlet velocity to the nozzle is negligible, what is the final velocity? Okay, so simple question, guys, but you need to go with this step by step. Okay, so first let me draw here some kind of turbine. So this is a turbine. Okay, so let me mark this entry as 1. So this is 0.1, so this is 0.2, and after this it is entering into what? Some nozzle. Okay, so this is nozzle. this is turbine, okay, and this is a nozzle, and this is the third point. This is a third point. So let me write what are the inputs given to us. Entering at pressure 10 bar. So P1 is 10 bar, entry pressure, T1 is 1000 Kelvin, leaves at a pressure of what? P2 equal to 5 bar. Subsequently, it expanded in a nozzle to a pressure of 1 bar means P3 equal to 1 bar. Both processes are reversible adiabatic, inlet velocity is negligible. So this V2 is negligible, 0. V2 is negligible. He is asking you what is the value of this V3? What is the value of the exit velocity from the nozzle? And guys, easily you will get this answer. Guys, here we want this. So first focus on this only. We want this velocity. What is the nozzle, guys? This is a steady flow device. Nozzle is a steady flow device, guys. Steady flow device. So we can use here the steady flow energy equation. Okay. And what is steady flow energy equation, guys? H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus ZZ1 plus Q equal to, okay, small q you can write here. So small q, okay, equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2 plus ZZ2 plus WCB. Okay, in nozzle, you know, here there is no such heat transfer given, so heat transfer is 0. In nozzle, there is no work transfer, this is 0. Inlet velocity is negligible, so this is 0. This is 0. Inlet velocity is given to us, negligible. Okay, there is no such data pad given at the entry and exit. So we can assume the negligible change in the potential energy. So this is both are equal. ZZ1 is approximately equal to ZZ2. So if you reduce this equation, you will get H1 minus H2 equal to C2 square by 2, or C2 equal to 2 under root 2 H1 minus H2. So this is the equation you are going to get, and this is nothing but V2, guys. I have written this earlier as V2, the exit velocity. Okay, let me write it here 2 and 3. It is better to write it here 2 and 3. Because for nozzle, the two points which we have considered, those two points are what, guys? Those two points are 2 and 3. Okay, those two points are 2 and 3. So let me write it here because that will be better. Okay, so let me write it here H2 plus V2 square by 2 plus ZZ2 plus Q equal to H3 plus V3 square by 2 plus ZZ3 plus WCV. Why actually I am writing this? Because for nozzle, inlet to the nozzle is 2, exit to the nozzle is 3. So this is 0, this is 0, this is 0, okay, this is 0, and these are approximately same. So you can write it here V3 equal to under root 2 into H2 minus H3. This you can write. And guys, for ideal gas, if you are assuming, and it is given, for ideal gas, the change in enthalpy, you can write it something like this, under root 2 Cp into T2 minus T3. 2 Cp T2 minus T3. But guys, one thing you need to understand, okay? If you are putting this Cp in joule per kg Kelvin, it's fine, then you will get the right answer. But if you want to put this in kilojoule per kg Kelvin, then here in place of 2, you need to write 2000. So don't do that kind of mistake. Like if this direct formula, if you want to use, like this V3, the exit velocity to the nozzle is not, but using all these assumptions, it is 2 Cp into T2 minus T1, okay? T2 minus T3. So don't put this Cp in kilojoule per kg Kelvin. If you will put this in kilojoule per kg Kelvin, you will get the wrong answer. Why? Because the SI unit of the velocity is meter per second. And you cannot use here kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, then you need to use joule per kg Kelvin. So let us try to find out this. So under root 2, Cp is given to us. I think this temperature is not given, T2. And T2 we can evaluate. Okay, T2 hum nikalenge. T2, T3 both are not given to us. Okay, Cp is given to us. Let me check, Cp is given to us or not. Cp is 1000 joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so this is 1000 joule per kg Kelvin. T2 minus T3, but we don't know these two temperatures. Ye hume nahi pata. And from where, guys, you will get these two temperatures? Do temperatures kahan se aayenge? Let me again came back to here. T2 and T3, we are interested in now finding this T2 and T3. Easily you will get, guys, because this is given to you reversible adiabatic. Okay, if you are having a reversible adiabatic process, you can write it here P2 by p1 ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma, this is equal to what guys? T2 by T1. Okay, so T2 equal to T1, T1 is 1000, 1000 to P2 is 5 bar, P1 is this 10 bar, so this is 5 by 10 ki power 0.4 divided by 1.4. okay, isko solve karoge bachcho, you will get T2, isko solve karoge, you will get T2. Please check what value of T2 you are getting. So you, if you will solve this, you will get value 820.33. This is the value you are going to get. Okay, similarly here to here also the expansion, the sorry, that conversion, because you are reducing the pressure energy, increasing the kinetic energy. Okay, so here also you can apply this relationship. Why? Because the process is given to you what? Reversible adiabatic. So you can write it here, T3 by T2 equal to P3 by P2 ki power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T3 equal to T2, and T2 is given, we evaluated 820.33 into P3. P3 is what guys? 1. So 1, P2 is what? 5. So 1 by 5 ki power, power you can write it here, gamma minus 1 by gamma, so it is 0.4 divided by 1.4. so solving this you will get T3. Okay, you will get T3 also 517.54. okay, 94. So this answer value you are going to get. So now guys, if you will put these values here, T3 and this T2 value, if you will put it here, in dono values ko agar aap yahan put karte hain, V3 equal to under root 2000 into T2 minus T3. So 820.33 minus 517.94. okay, so if you'll put these values here, you will get the answer. Okay, aapke paas answer aa jayega V3, exit velocity to the nozzle. Please try to find out what value you are getting. So if you'll solve this guys, you will get velocity close to 777.67 meter per second. This is the velocity you are going to get. Okay, so 777.67 meter per second. Okay, one decimal tak aapko karna hai, to 777.7, that is the answer you can write. Okay, and for this question the acceptable range is 770 to 785. This is the acceptable range. Okay, acceptable range for this question, 770 to 785. Chaliye, let us move to next question guys. Some diagram is given, TS diagram, temperature entropy diagram. Dekho PV diagram dekh ke hamare dimag mein kya aata hai, the area under the curve on the PV diagram when projected on the volume axis is going to give us the work transfer in that particular process. Similarly, the area under the curve on TS diagram when projected on entropy axis is going to give us the heat transfer in that process. So in TS diagram is given to you, he is asking the heat transfer from where? 1 to 3, he is asking the heat transfer, and that heat transfer is nothing but this entire area. So if you are able to find out this entire area, you will get the answer. This entire area you need to evaluate. Okay, तो इसको आप क्या कर सकते हो, you can divide it into three parts. Three में करना चाहो, दो में करना चाहो, you can divide according to your requirement. Okay, so I am dividing it something like this. So you can divide in three parts. Okay, something like this. So I am considering this as part one, this is part two, this is part three. So the heat transfer in the process 1 to 3 will be what guys? This is the entire area. Okay, and how you can write that entire area guys? Isko likhoge ye area kya hoga bacho? This will be what? The entropy change. This entropy change means 0.5 multiplied by 300. This area, 1. Entropy change in kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so what you will get? You will get in what? 0.5 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Multiply by temperature, you will get kilojoule per kg. So this is the heat transfer in kilojoule per kg. We also want answer in what? Kilojoule per kg. Okay, so this is area 1 plus, what is the area 2? It is half into base into height. Again, what is the base? Base is 0.5. What is the height, guys? Height kya hoga iski? What is the height of this? Height is 450 minus 300, so the height is 150. Height is 150, so this is area 2. What is area 3, guys? Area 3 is base. Base is what? 0.15 multiply by height. So height is what? 450. So this is 450. Okay. So if you solve this, guys, you will get the heat transfer. Very simple question. 2 marks ka isse asan question nahi ho sakta in gate examination. So if you solve, this will come out 150. Okay. Isko isse karoge, it will come out because ye 1/4 ho jayega. So 150 ka 1/4 will be 75. 75 divided by 2, it will be 37.5. Okay. Plus. इसको इससे करोगे देन ऑल्सो यू कैन सोल्व सो इट विल बी 45 ओके 45 का मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1.5 करोगे सो यू विल गेट व्हाट इसको 20 प्लस 22.5 ओके सो हाँ यस ओके सो 45 प्लस 22.5 सो यू विल गेट 67.5 ओके 67.5 सो दिस यू विल ऐड यू विल गेट 100 सो आई एम गेटिंग 250 किलो जूल पर केजी Okay, 250 kilojoule per kg. This is the heat transfer in this process. Let us check. We are evaluating this right or wrong. Okay. So 150, 375.5. Okay, guys, it will be what? यहाँ पे हमने एक चीज कर दी. Yes. So this add. If you will add this, this is not 100. Okay, this is not 100, this is what? This is 105. You need to check. This is 70. If you will add this in 32.5, then it will be 100. So this will come out what? 250. Okay, that's a mistake. So here you can write 255. Okay, why? Because 150 plus 105, you will get 255. So heat transfer in this process is 255 kilojoule per kg. So this is the answer and you can write it here 255 kilojoule per kg. So let us move to guys next question, question number 64. In a simple Rankine cycle, superheated steam enters the turbine. So let us draw the Rankine cycle something like this. So this is the temperature versus entropy diagram. You can draw here the phase change. So the saturated superheated steam entering the turbine something like this. This temperature, this pressure, entropy, enthalpy is also given to us at that particular point. The rate of steam flow is also given. Expanded isentropically in the turbine to the condenser pressure, the temperature in the condenser is 30 degrees Celsius. So here the temperature is what? 30 degrees Celsius. The condenser temperature is 30 degrees Celsius and this particular temperature is what? Okay, this particular temperature. This particular temperature is 500 degree Celsius. HF, HG are given at condenser pressure. SF, SG are also given. Saturated water from the condenser. So here you are having saturated water. So this point, at this point, you are having saturated water. Okay, and this saturated water is pumped back to the boiler. Okay, neglecting the pump work, he is saying neglect the pump work. Pump work ko aap kya kar do? Neglect kar do. Okay. Neglecting the pump work, what is the efficiency of this particular Rankine cycle? Okay. He is asking you the efficiency. आपसे क्या पूछ रहा है बच्चों? आपसे पूछ रहा है वो efficiency. What is the efficiency of this? Okay, so the cycle will be something like this. This is a cycle. We don't know what is the dryness fraction here because this data is not given to us. Ki at the exit of the turbine, you are having the saturated vapor or what? That is not given to us. Okay, so let me write it here. This is 0.1, this is 0.2, this is 0.3, this is 0.4 and this is 5. Okay, so the cycle will be something like this. Cycle will be something like this. He is asking you the efficiency of this Rankine cycle, neglecting the pump work. So what is efficiency, guys? It is net work output divided by heat supplied. Okay, so net work is one means turbine work minus pump work, and clearly he has mentioned ki neglect the pump work. So it is W net will be what? W turbine by heat supplied. Okay, W turbine you can write it as H1 minus H2. W turbine you can write it as H1 minus H2. Capital H1 H2 also you can write because mass is given to us 1000 kg per second. Okay, heat supplied is what guys? Heat supplied kya ho jayega? It will be H1 minus H4. H1 minus H4. Okay, so first thing which you can write it here guys, in place of H4 you can directly write it here H3. Why? Because pump work is zero. Okay, what is pump work guys? WP which is zero, neglect karna hai, neglect. So what is this guys? This is nothing but H4 minus H3. So if pump work is zero, the exit enthalpy is almost equal to the inlet enthalpy H3, and H3 is given to us. In this question guys, H1 we know, enthalpy at the turbine entry, this is given to us. Let me write it here, H1. Kitna hai bacho? This is 3375.1. This is given to us. And from this, H4 equal to H3, this is equal to HF at condenser pressure at 30 degrees Celsius. This is also given to us, 125.74. Okay. So these three enthalpies are known to us. If you are able to evaluate this H2, you will get the answer, you will get the efficiency. But from where you will get the H2 guys? H2 kahan se aayega? H2 you will get from H3 plus X2 into HFG at what? At 30 degrees Celsius. So this you we know, this we know, H3 also we know. So if you want to find out H2, easily you will evaluate if you know X2. But from where you will get X2 guys? X2 या X, directly X लिखना चाहो, X लिख सकते हो, or you can write X2 also. So here, if you want to find out the dryness fraction, what you need to do guys? You need to equate. किसको equate करना पड़ेगा? You need to equate S1 equal to S2. Because 1 to 2 is what? Isentropic expansion process. Okay, 1 to 2 is isentropic expansion process. So S1 is the turbine entry, and at the turbine entry, entropy is given to us 6.59, 6.5995. This is the entropy at the turbine entry. What is S2? How we can write S2? S2 is again S3 plus X2 into S3, S2 minus S3. Okay, sorry, SFG mein likh deta hun usko. SFG. Okay, at what? At condenser pressure at 30 degrees Celsius. Okay, so solving this, you will get X2 guys. Isko solve karoge, you will get X2. Okay, so let me write it here. 6.5995 equal to S3. What is the entropy at the you can say at this point 3? What is that? That is SF at condenser pressure, and SF at condenser pressure is this 0.4368 plus X2 into SG minus SF, that is SFG at condenser pressure. So this is nothing but 8.4520 minus 0.4368. Okay, so if you solve this, you will get X2. Okay, isko solve karoge, you will get guys X2. Please try to find out and tell me what value of X2 you are getting. X2 you will get, let me write it here in front of you. X2 you will get 0.78. This is the dryness fraction you will get at the turbine exit. Okay, because at the turbine exit you will get a mixture of saturated liquid and saturated vapor. Okay, and guys, now if you will put this value 768 guys, 0.768, this is the value you are going to get. Okay, and this value if you will put it here guys, you will get H2. So H2 equal to H3, and H3 is 125.74 plus 0.768 into HFG, and HFG is nothing but guys what? It is HG 2556. Okay, let me write it here again. So this minus, because this is HG guys, HG minus HF. Okay, HG minus HF. HF is what? 125.74. Okay, 125.74, ओके, इसको सोल्व करोगे बच्चों, यू विल गेट H2 एंथैल्पी एट द टर्बाइन एग्जिट एंड दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू फाइंड आउट दिस एफिशिएंसी, ओके, प्लीज इवेल्युएट एंड टेल मी व्हाट वैल्यू ऑफ H2 यू आर गेटिंग, इफ यू विल सोल्व दिस गाइस, यू विल गेट ए वैल्यू क्लोज टू 1991.87 किलो जूल पर केजी, ओके, दिस इज द एंथैल्पी यू आर गोइंग टू गेट. And if you'll put this value here, guys, if you'll put this value here, let me write it here. H1 is 3375.1 minus H2. We evaluated H2 1991.87 divided by H1 3375.1 minus H4. And H4 is also given to us, guys. H3, it is 125.74. Okay. 125.74, ओके, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट एफिशियंसी इन परसेंटेज, एफिशियंसी अपने को किस में पूछा है बच्चों, द नेग्लेक्टिंग द परफेक्ट, द एफिशियंसी इन परसेंटेज, यस, एफिशियंसी इन परसेंटेज, सो इफ यू वॉन्ट एफिशियंसी इन परसेंटेज यू नीड टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस एंटायर टर्म विद 100, अदरवाइज यू विल गेट एफिशियंसी इन फ्रैक्शन, ओके, तो परसेंटेज में अपने को एफिशियंसी चाहिए बच्चों, एंड इफ यू विल कैरी आउट द सिंप्लीफिकेशन you will get your answer 337.51 minus this divided by this you will get efficiency close to 42.56%, okay, so the thermal efficiency will come out 42.56%, okay, and this is the answer guys for this question, please check, very good question, many time similar type of question were asked in gate XE, okay, range for this question is you can check what is the range, okay, efficiency is this, let me write the range 41 to 43.5, okay, so the range for this question is 41 to 43.5, we are getting answer close to 42 point something, but this is the acceptable range 41 to 43.5, very wider range, okay, so even if you are like when simplifying, if you are missing some term, okay, like higher term, if you are not taking decimal after decimal, then also you will get the answer in this range, okay, otherwise in gate you need to consider at least up to 3 decimal point you need to consider, okay, chaliye, let us now move to guys next question, this is our second last question guys for the today's session, question number 21 and 65th question in this particular series, okay, total question, you know guys, in for 11 years 11 saal ke apne ko question solve karne hai, so you are going to solve question close to 242, total 242 question we are going to solve. So in that 242 question series, this is question number 65. Okay, a rigid adiabatic container has two parts A and B. So there is a rigid adiabatic container. Okay, something like this. Adiabatic container means there is no heat transfer from this. Isse heat transfer kya hai bachcho? That is zero. There is no heat transfer. Okay, there are two parts. There are two parts which are separated by a piston. So this is actually a piston. This is actually a piston, okay, इसको हम piston बोल सकते हैं, and there is a part A and part B, these are the two parts, in part A is filled with some ideal gas, 1 kg, यहाँ पे क्या है, 1 kg ideal gas, okay, with CV this, R this, 1 bar, pressure कितना है बच्चों, 1 bar, okay, 600 Kelvin, temperature is also given to you 600 Kelvin, part B is filled with 1 kg of the same gas, 1 kg same gas means their properties are same, CP, CV, R, all are same because the, both are the same gases, okay, but here the mass is what, again 1 kg, the pressure is 2 kg, P2, here the pressure is 2 bar, the pressure is 2 bar and the temperature here is 400 Kelvin, the piston is now removed and in the final state, what is the final pressure, he is asking you the final pressure means what guys, final pressure after mixing, it is actually a mixing process, final pressure after mixing, okay, mixing ke baad aapse kya pooch raha hai, final pressure pooch raha hai, very simple question guys, easily you will be able to evaluate this, you know guys, in mixing, mixing is actually a very fast process, although it is given this container is adiabatic, but if it is not given, then also you can assume mixing as a adiabatic process, because mixing takes very less time actually, very quick process, and in that quick process you can neglect the heat transfer, because heat transfer requires some kind of time, okay, so heat transfer is zero, there is no heat transfer, also in this case, you know, we have not attached any kind of system to utilize work. Okay, there is no such device attached to get any kind of work. So work transfer is also zero. यहाँ पे वर्क भी क्या है बच्चों, जीरो है. सो हीट ट्रांसफर जीरो, वर्क ट्रांसफर जीरो. सो इफ यू विल राइट इट हेयर, डी क्यू इक्वल टू डी यू प्लस डी डब्ल्यू फॉर ए प्रोसेस इन ए क्लोज सिस्टम. दिस इज ए क्लोज सिस्टम एंड फॉर एनी प्रोसेस इन ए क्लोज सिस्टम, इफ दिस इज जीरो, दिस इज जीरो, देन दिस डी यू विल ऑल्सो बी जीरो. इट मीन्स इनिशियल इंटरनल एनर्जी दैट इज इक्वल टू फाइनल इंटरनल एनर्जी. बोथ आर आइडियल गैस, सो यू कैन राइट इट हेयर सी वी. ओके, एम सी वी T1, okay, MCV T1, okay, that is equal to what? अभी ये final होगा. This is internal energy initial, so this is the initial internal energy U1. But after mixing के बाद क्या हो जाएगा? Masses you will have what? Masses अभी आप यहाँ पे आपको लिखना पड़ेगा. Let me write it here. Initial internal energy means what? Initial internal energy means the internal energy before mixing. Okay, and that you can write it as M1. Like chamber 1, I am writing it as 1. So this is chamber 1 and this is chamber 2. Because in place of A and B, I want to use expression 1 and 2. Okay, so you can write it here M1, CV, because CV is same, because both are same gases. So M1 CV T1 plus M2 CV T2. T1 T2 are same. Different masses are same, okay, but masses can be different also. Both are same gases, so their CV CV will be same. Okay, this is equal to U2. U2 will be what, guys? M1 plus M2. This is mass CV into what? Yahan pe kya likhna padega apne ko? T final. M1 CV T1 plus M2 CV T2, that is equal to M1 plus M2 CV T final. So guys, if you will simplify this, CV, CV, CV will be cancel out. So the T final, directly also you can remember for these type of cases, you will get T final equal to M1 T1 plus M2 T2 divided by M1 plus M2. Okay, so M1 is 1, M2 is also 1, T1 is 600 Kelvin, T2 is 400 Kelvin. So if you will solve this, 600 plus 400, so 1 into 600 plus 1 into 400 divided by 1 plus 1, so you will get this 500 Kelvin. So 500 Kelvin is the final temperature, but we want final pressure. Hame kya chahiye bachcho? Final pressure. Okay, from where you will get final pressure, guys? You know ideal gas equation, P1V equal to what? P1V1 equal to M1 R T1, yes or no? P1V1 equal to M1 R T1. Okay. Similarly, P2V2 equal to M2 R T2. Yes or no? P1V1 equal to M1 R T1. P2V2 equal to M2 R T2. Okay. And also you can write it here, P final equal to V final equal to M final. And M final is nothing but M1 plus M2 R T final. Okay, so from this equation, you will get P final. Okay, so P final is nothing but M1 plus M2 into R, characteristic gas constant, T final divided by V final. Okay, P final from this. And guys, from this, easily, you can evaluate V1 plus V2. And evaluating V1 plus V2, V1 is what, guys? V1 is M1 R T1 by P1. Okay, V2 is what? M2 R T2 by P2. Okay, so let us put, because we know the masses, let me check what is the value of R is given to us. Okay, R is given to us 500 joule. Okay, R is given to us 500 joule. So let me write it here. Mass is 1, R is 500 joule into T1 is 600. Pressure P1 is 1 bar, P2 is 2 bar. So let me write it here, P1 is 1 bar. So 1 into 10 key power 5, because in Newton per meter square you need to put. Okay, so if you will solve this, guys, you will get the answer. Isko solve karoge, you will get this. I think this will come out 3, because this 10 key power 4 will be cancelled out. This multiply with this, you will get 30. 30 by 10, you will get 3 meter square. Okay, 3 meter cube. Okay, similarly from this also you will get the answer. 1 into R is again 500, T2 is 400 divided by 2 into 10 की पावर 5. ओके, सो इसको सोल्व करोगे 20 डिवाइड बाय 10 यू विल गेट 2, 2 बाय 2 यू विल गेट 1 मीटर क्यूब. ओके, सो V1 इज 3 मीटर क्यूब, V2 इज 1 मीटर क्यूब एंड V फाइनल विल बी व्हाट, गाइस? v final will be some 4 meter cube. Okay, so if you put all the values here, m1 plus m2 is 2 into r is 500 into t final, you can evaluate v final is what, 4. Okay, so you will get the answer. T final you will get from here, t final is 500. Okay, 500, and if you will solve this 2, you will get it here 250. Okay, you will get 250. So let us try to solve. It will come out 125 into 10 to the power 3. So you can write it as 1.25 bar. I am getting this answer 1.25 bar. You can also check your answer, what answer you are getting. Okay, I am getting 1.25 bar. Okay, so this is the final pressure we are getting after mixing. Okay guys, so the answer for this question is final pressure is 1.25 bar. Units you need to check guys. Aapko units check karna padega. Answer aapse kise pucha hai? Bar mein pucha hai, yes. Okay, so first we obtain, like solving this you will get answer in kilopascal, like in Newton per meter square. And Newton per meter square you can easily convert into bar. Chaliye, let us move to the last question guys. This is the last question. And 66th question in this particular series. In a steady flow process, superheated steam at 70 bar 450 degrees Celsius is throttled to 30 bar in an insulated valve. Okay. At a rate of 2 kg per second, the change in kinetic energy and potential energy during the process are assumed to be zero. Throttling process hai, kinetic energy, potential energy changes are neglected. So what you will have guys? Enthalpy in equal to enthalpy out, because throttling is an isenthalpic process. Okay, neglecting the kinetic and potential energy changes. The rate of entropy generation he is asking you. So, if I will draw here, this is a throttling device. This is a throttling device. Okay, suppose this is state 1, this is state 2. Okay, he is asking you the entropy generation. Guys, entropy generation kya hota hai bachon? This is nothing but change in entropy of the universe. So this is nothing but change in entropy of the system plus change in entropy of the surrounding. Okay, guys, throttling is a what? You know, the area of the throttling device is very negligible. So throttling, we assume it as a adiabatic device. Okay, let us see here also. I think somewhere he mentioned about the insulated valve. Throttling is an insulated valve. Clearly he has mentioned here also. Throttling is an insulated valve. Okay, insulated valve means there is no such heat transfer from that. Okay, otherwise also you can assume if there is no such data given. Okay, so if there is no heat transfer from throttling, if there is no heat transfer, so what is the entropy change of the surrounding? That's entropy change of the surrounding will also be zero. Why? Because in surrounding there is no heat is going, you are not taking any heat from the surrounding, and also there is no heat transfer to the surrounding. So entropy change of the surrounding will be zero. Okay, now you need to find out the entropy change of this. Enthalpy entropy are both at given, like at this entry exit pe aapko entropy kya hai given hai. Okay, so in a steady flow device, entry at what, 70 bar 70 bar pe enter kar raha hai. The superheated steam is entering at 70 bar 450 degrees Celsius. So here we know the inlet entropy 70 bar pe, okay, 30 70 bar pe, and at this particular temperature the entropy is given to us. So we can write it here S1. So S1 is nothing but 6.6353 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So this is directly given to us. What is S2? If you know S2, then only you need to take the difference of S2 minus S1, you will get the answer. Because entropy change of the gas, entropy change of the system is nothing but that is entropy generation, because entropy change of the surrounding is zero. So what, from where you will get this S2? Abhi kuch bachche isme mistake kya karenge? They will take at 30 bar, because the exit is what? Exit is 30 bar. Exit is 30 bar, but what is the exit temperature? You don't know. You don't know the exit temperature. If you know the exit temperature, like 400 or 450, then exactly you can take the exit entropy out of this 400 or 450. At 2 temperature, 30 bar corresponding to 400 degree Celsius entropy is given. 30 bar corresponding to 450 degree Celsius entropy is given. But which one you need to take? 400 or 450? So some student, they think the steam throttling you are carrying out and it is an isenthalpy process, and then T1 will be equal to T2. Guys, T1 is equal to T2 for ideal gas and steam is not an ideal gas. So you cannot take exit temperature exactly 450. I think we don't know. Here we don't know what is the exit temperature, although you can try to evaluate that, but here we don't know, okay, what is the exit temperature. But one thing we know, the exit enthalpy is equal to the inlet enthalpy. What is inlet enthalpy, guys? The inlet enthalpy H1 is 3288.3, this is inlet enthalpy, and the exit enthalpy H2 equal to what? Exit enthalpy is also same, there is no need to evaluate that, 3288.3 kilojoule per kg. Okay, so if you will check this enthalpy 3288, this is neither this, means the exit temperature is in between 400 and 450. Are you getting this idea, guys? The inlet, and because that we can assume throttling is an, neglecting kinetic and potential energy changes, throttling is an isenthalpic process. So this is the inlet enthalpy at this pressure, this temperature. This is the inlet enthalpy. This is the inlet enthalpy, guys. And this same is the exit enthalpy. And if you check the enthalpy at 400 is 3231. This is 3344, and if you will check this value lies between these two values, means the exit enthalpy, the exit temperature is in between 400 and 450. So how you will evaluate the exit entropy? For that you need to go with linear interpolation. What is that? Let me tell you. Okay, linear interpolation aapko lagana padega bachcho. Main yahan aapko idea de deta hun. What is that linear interpolation? Okay, so guys, here we can take enthalpy, here we can take entropy. At any two point, if you know the enthalpy or entropy, you can find out respective other value also using linear interpolation. So guys, here if you will assume this particular temperature 400, suppose if you will assume 400 temperature, okay, 400 temperature assume karte hain, okay, so at 400 temperature, what is this entropy? This is 6.9235. This is at 400 temperature. What is the enthalpy here? This is 3231.7. Okay. What is the enthalpy at here? S2 means here. Suppose if you will assume this temperature, if you will assume 450 degrees Celsius, so the entropy is what? 7.0856. Okay. And here the enthalpy is what, guys? Enthalpy is 3344.9. Okay. So this enthalpy we know. This enthalpy we know, this entropy we know. Okay, this is at what? 400 degrees Celsius. This is corresponding to 400 degrees Celsius. This is corresponding to 450 degrees Celsius. At what? At 30 bar. Okay, exit enthalpy we know. We are interested to find out the exit entropy. What is exit enthalpy, guys? The exit enthalpy is in between this, and the exit enthalpy is 3288.3 kilojoule per kg. This is the exit enthalpy. 3.2, this is in between these two values. This is the exit enthalpy. Corresponding to this, we want this exit entropy. We want this entropy, guys. Hame kya chahiye? Hame ye chahiye. This is S2. We are interested in finding out this S2 exit entropy, and that easily you will get using linear interpolation. What is that linear interpolation, guys? Consider it as a triangle. Isko ek triangle maan lo. And consider this is tangent theta, and this is same for this larger triangle and for this smaller triangle. There are two triangles. One is the larger triangle and one is the smaller triangle. Okay. So here you can write the simple relationship. Ek simple relationship aap yahan likh sakte ho. For the larger triangle, what is the perpendicular, guys? The perpendicular is 3344.9. This is the perpendicular minus 3231.7. Okay, this is perpendicular. What is base? The base is 7.0856 minus 6.9235. Okay, for the larger triangle, guys, this is the perpendicular, this is the base. For the smaller triangle, what is the perpendicular? The perpendicular is 3288.3 minus, this is perpendicular, minus this 3231.7. This is perpendicular. What is base? Base is S2 minus this value 6.9235. Okay, linear interpolation means the properties they are varying linearly. Okay, so enthalpy we know, entropy we want to find out, and we are assuming they are varying linearly. So this is tangent theta, this will be same for the both larger triangle and smaller triangle. And if you will go with this linear interpolation, guys, easily you will be able to evaluate exit entropy. Okay, so let me write it here. What is the value of exit entropy you will get? So if you solve this, guys, you will get 7.00455 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so this is the exit entropy you will get using linear interpolation. And if you will put this value here, entropy change of the system is S2 minus S1. Okay, so S2 is what? 7.00455. Okay. Minus inlet entropy. Inlet entropy, we know this is 6.6353. Okay. Isko solve karoge, you will get entropy generation because entropy change of the surrounding is zero. And if you solve this, guys, you will get the answer 0.36925 in kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay. Let us check in what unit answer is asked to you. Okay, so delta S generation we are getting this, and if we'll check the entropy change in kilojoule per second Kelvin, he's asking the rate of entropy generation. Okay, agar aapko rate of entropy generation nikalna hai bachcho, if you want rate of entropy generation, so for that you need to multiply mass flow rate of the steam from the throttling device, and then you need to multiply this entropy generation. So if you multiply mass flow rate of the steam, let us check if some data is given. Yes, mass flow rate of the steam is given to us 2 kg per second. So you can write it here, 2 kg per second multiply by this 0.36925, you will get answer in kilojoule per second Kelvin. Kilojoule per second Kelvin, this is the answer you are going to get in these units. Okay, so the answer will be close to 0.7385 kilojoule per second Kelvin. This is the answer you are going to get. Please check if whether you are getting this answer or not. 0.7385. Okay, guys, and the acceptable range for this question is 0.700 to 0.750 in kilojoule per second Kelvin. Okay, this is the range, and yes, we are getting exact mid of this. Okay, guys, so please check if you have solved this question or not. Very good question, last question tha, but bahut acha question hai from refrigeration throttling device, basic thermodynamics question, you can say. Okay, so these are the old question, guys, from the year 2019 paper, Gate XE. 22 questions we have solved. Again, we will meet and we will solve some 22 questions from the paper 2018. Okay, I hope you all are practicing different questions from these type of previous year question also, and from the practice session also, practice question also, those we are sharing with you. Okay, thank you very much. Have a nice day. Keep preparing.